Cardmaking friends, Sandi MacIver here. Today I'm sharing inspiration created with the Take Time For You Project Kit from Fun Stamper's Journey. It consists of the Plant Lady stamp set, this Journey Tropical Sunrise stickers, and there are two die sets. The first one is the Plant Lady die set, and it cuts out the plants from the stamp set that I just showed you, this one right here. And I do not think it has a die for the cat or the lady in the chair. The second die set is called Happy Plants, and there isn't a stamp set that goes with it, but near the end of the video, I'm going to cut it out and I'm going to show you how all the images piece together to make really, really awesome plants. First off, I'm going to create three cards, and they're kind of minimalistic cards, lots of black and white, and then just a pop of the green and the turquoise. And I'm using my Misti, and I'm going to be stamping all of these images in alcohol ink friendly ink onto white cardstock, and I'm going to be using my Copic markers to color them. While I have my Misti out, I'm going to do the black and white stamping that I need for the background for my first card. So I've got the lady in the chair on the left-hand side, and I've got the cat on the very right-hand side. And again, I'm stamping these just in black, and they're on white card. So now I'm going to color the plants that are going to accompany these guys on this card. So again, I'm starting with Copic markers, and I've got three colors for each of the two color families. And I color light to dark with each one of these. For the green, it's YG03, YG23, and YG67. And what I'm doing right now is I am flooding the entire leaf with the lightest color, which is the YG03. And that's my base color. It's going to get right down into that white paper and get me prepped for the second color, which is the YG23. And what I'm doing here is I'm coloring just the tips of the two little guys over on the right hand side, and then I'm going to use the flicking technique on both sides, the outside edge and the inside edge of the larger leaf. So again, I'm flicking with the YG23, and first off I'm going around the outside edge of each of the leaves. And then I'm going to come back and do the center. And I'm only using two colors on this one because I didn't want the darker color on it. I find that sometimes the leaves are nice and shiny and a really, really bright green when they first come out. And that's kind of what I'm doing with this one. And so the reason I started with the black and white was because most of the images on here are black and white, and I really like these plant pots in black and white, but I'm going to add just a little bit of turquoise to the bottom. The turquoise colors that I'm using are BG11, BG13, and BG49, and again, I'm only using the first two on this plant pot, so I go in with the 11, and then I highlight with the 13, and then go back and blend again with the 11. So for the rubber tree, I'm going to use all three of the greens, and so I'm starting once again with the BG11, I'm going to flood the entire area of all of the leaves. And this kind of preps the paper for me, getting the alcohol ink down into it, which is going to allow the other two colors to blend in for me. And this is really simple coloring. I'm, you know, just keeping it really, really simple. So my middle color is the YG23, and I'm coming in with that. And then I'm going to come in with the darkest color, the YG67, and I'm just going to add a tiny, tiny little bit of shadow at the tips of each of the leaves. And then I'm going to come back in with my YG03, and I'm going to blend all three of those colors together, and I'm starting from the center and kind of flicking out to spread those colors around. I find these colorings just very calming. Do you like coloring and finding it calming? Okay, so now it's time to do the plant pot. And again, I'm using the same three turquoise colors, the BG 11, 13, and 49. And I'm coming in with the 11, and I'm turning it sideways because I just find it easier to color that way. So I'm flooding the entire pot with the 11, and then I'm going to use the flicking technique from both sides and add the next two colors. This is the BG 13. And I want kind of my highlight to be over on the right-hand side on all of them. So I'm there. I get in closer for you. Makes it a little bit easier to see. So I've come back with my BG11 and I'm blending all the colors together, and you can still see the lines from the BG49. So I'm going back in with the BG13, adding that as a middle layer, and then coming back in with the 11 and blending it. And this time it blends really nicely. So I'm moving on to my little snake plant, and I'm going to do that pot first just because I happen to have the blues in my hand when I flipped over to that one. And again, this pot is nice and easy, lots of black in it. And then for the snake, for the plant itself, I flood the entire thing with the YG03. And then I'm going to draw my lines with the YG23. And I'm going all the way across each leaf with that. And I'm going to come in with the YG67, and I'm going to add just a dash on the left-hand side of each of the leaves. And then I come back in with YG23, and I'm going to pull that dark color all the way across the leaf. That gives it a really nice highlight. And it keeps all the darkness over to the left-hand side because I've got kind of my light on the right-hand side of each of the images. So I think this last one is a prayer plant. And so I'm going to use the three colors again because the prayer plants are very variegated. And this is the second, the middle color, the 23. I'm going in adding just lines in the center. And then I'm going to do the same thing with my YG67. Add some dark lines, but they're little short ones. And then coming back in with the YG03 and just kind of blending those in a little bit so they're not so kind of separated. And I'm repeating on this pot again, starting with the 11, then adding the 13 and the 49 in my flicking, and coming back and blending in with the 11. And off camera, I did a bunch more of these because I did enough for all three of the cards so I could show you how to put them together. And I just wanted to color these ones for you as the rest of them are all repeats. So you get an idea of each one of these and how I colored it. So I'm just coming back in with my 11 and doing my blending. And coming back in with my 13, adding that second color in. That helps blend the 49 in a little bit so it doesn't stick out quite so much. So there we go, we're all ready. And now I can add the dies over top of them and run them through my Platinum 6 machine and die cut all the pieces that I need for the cards. Okay, so as I said, I did all the extra ones off camera and I've got them all laid out to make sure I have all the pieces. Let's start with the lady in the chair, and I'm going to take some of the foam squares and cut them into smaller pieces and put them on the back of my two plants, and then I dry fit them to make sure I've got them where I want them before I peel off the protective backing and add them permanently to my card. And I do the rubber tree first because I've got the cat's nose going right in against the stem, and then that leaves me the maximum room for the other little prayer print to go in beside. So now I just need to add the sentiment. So I've popped this back into my Misty, and I'm adding the sentiment near the top center, just off to the right a little bit, and I'm just using the same black ink to stamp my sentiment, and apparently I'm stamping it twice because I didn't get it inked very well. That happens. And there we go. There's the first card done. Moving on to the second card. Well, I've got the Misty out, I'm going to stamp the sentiment for this one. So again, I'm dry fitting my completed art elements onto my card front so I know where I can add my sentiment. Removing my art pieces just in case I have some black ink. I don't want to wreck the ones that I've already colored. And again, stamping a couple of times to get that little hello in there nice and dark. And now I am ready to go. And I'm going to take the BG11 and I'm going to use the chisel tip. And I'm just going to add a little bit of color where the plants are going to go on the plant. So it just adds a little bit of background. Or as I just showed you, you could add some splatter. And speaking of splatter, that happens to be the background for card number 3. So just a bit of black paint, watered it down with a bit of water and splattered it on there and let it dry. And then I white heaped embossed the hello onto a scrap of black card. And I'm just trimming it out. I'm going to add some foam squares to the back of it and permanently attach it to the card base. And then I've got small pieces of foam on the back of the three little plants. And I did three of the same this time. And they're all the little prayer plant. And I've added them on just for a quick and easy card. So there you go. There's all three of my simple cards. I think that minimalistic cards are kind of fun, and they don't take very long, which is kind of cool. So on to the last of the dies. And this is the Happy Plants dies. And I have done each one, and I'm showing you which elements I use to make each one of these. Aren't they beautiful? I just really enjoyed cutting these out, and they cut like butter. They are fabulous. And so up next, I used a couple of Spellbinders dies to create some backgrounds behind where I'm going to be putting my plants. And I used a little bit of oatmeal cookie ink just around the edges with a sponge just to highlight them a little bit. And here they are finished. I added the sentiments from the Plant Lady stamp set as well. So again, three quick and easy cards, but I'll tell you, these dies are just fabulous to play with. I hope you enjoyed my collection for today on the Take Time For You bundle. And until next time, toodles!